Hey everybody, today I am unboxing my Hepco and Becker engine guards for my 2019 Honda Africa Twin. Trying to be careful with my knife here because if I cut myself, this will end up on some kind of blooper reel. Nice. So they promised that it would contain all of the necessary hardware. So we will see. Yeah, I'd say that chrome color matches up pretty good. All right, there are the bars, and here are the instructions. For this install, my best friend Matt volunteered his assistance and his garage, which meant that I got to ride up to Bailey, which was just absolutely gorgeous. Not a lot of traffic at 10 o'clock, and the weather was just creeping above 50 as I got up into the mountains. So this road here is a more direct way to get kind of to his house. And you can't really tell from the video, but the ground isn't actually flat, like paved blacktop. It's kind of that gravelly, hard-packed dirt on top of what was concrete or blacktop. So I would have liked to take it a little bit faster, but one, the car in front of me initially wasn't going too fast, and then two, I didn't want to have my back tire lose traction on any of the loose elements on the road. The weather forecast for the day was great. High 50s, low 60s. The ground thaw report, however, gave us a little bit of pause when we were discussing this trip and me coming up. On all the paved areas, it was great. Maybe a little bit of standing water. But once I got up onto his hill, there was the issue of snowpack that had turned to ice, and it freezes solid overnight. So it's essentially an ice skating rink, and he lives at the bottom of a huge hill. But I'm not scared, so I made the decision to go ahead and head up there, and worst case scenario, I guess we were pushing the bike up the hill. Worst case scenario, throwing it on a trailer and hauling it to the top of the hill, unloading it, and then riding back home. A few of these wet areas made me nervous too, because in the really shady areas, the wetness wasn't standing water, it was actually ice. And then of course you always have vehicles that come around corners in the middle of the road. And this road essentially drops us off right at the base of the dirt road that goes to his house. Now the stock tires did really good on this hard-packed mud, I'll call it. I only slipped a little bit on one spot. Now those areas on the left, it looks like mud, but really that's all still frozen at this point. And it's solid ice. So I really tried hard to hug the right side. Worst case scenario, I go into the soft shoulder against that dirt wall. Right back there is where I slid a little bit, but it grabbed. One thing that's hard to see too is right there, just to the right of middle, is a huge rut. And it's manageable, but at some points, you can't see it in the video, but it got pretty deep. So I was trying to avoid running into that. Then once I get to the top of the hill, I see, yep, solid ice going all the way down. So after talking about maybe walking it down through the woods, trying just to point my wheel straight and going down the hill, we actually decided to use the neighbor's driveway, which goes towards the bottom, because he actually scrapes it after snow, so it is pretty melted and just dirt. So just got to go nice and slow, practicing my balance. The trick is, for me, putting that front wheel exactly where you want it to be. Because really, you're concerned about where your back tire is, because that's where the acceleration and the traction comes from. So at this point, I'm feeling pretty good. Things are going smooth, then my front tire hits a rut and the carpet gets pulled right out from under me. And at this point, we're about 30 feet from his house. So make the decision, hey, let's just, it's icy, let's just walk it the rest of the way. The topic of tires came up, and I'm pretty sure that it didn't matter if I had knobby tires on there. Ice is ice, right? So we did check out the bike, check out the engine, make sure there weren't any gouges or scratches, and it looks like the fairing, crash bars, and actually the luggage rack took the brunt of the fall, and it wasn't a hard fall. But that's why we are here, to install engine crash bars, so that we can avoid from damaging and cracking the engine case right there. So once we had the muffler off in the back and also the skid plate, we had to take the header pipes directly off the engine right there by those motor mount brackets, so that we can actually get to those bolts right there on the frame. So we got the muffler off, got the skid plate off. Now right now, it's a matter of taking those motor mount bracket bolts off one at a time. Those two didn't have anything loaded on it, which was nice. But the one in the back we had to loosen had quite a bit of load. So there they are, installed. Hepco and Becker engine crash bars, got the muffler back on. Now I'll just work on getting the skid plate back on. So that was fun. We're leaving Bailey, heading back home. Make sure to subscribe, like the video, sign up for notifications. We will catch you guys next time. Oh,